Welcome to the India International Hospitality Export 2020, IHC 2020 Conclave. We have had a great opportunity to, it's now the second day of the conclave, and we already have heard some of the industry leaders talk about many of the issues thrown up by the COVID-19 pandemic. In fact, when we started our webinars at the peak of the lockdown, many months ago, we had the hope that by September, October, we will be welcoming a new dawn, you know. But that dawn is turning out to be a rather elusive creature, and we are still struggling in the dark. The only light we see at the end of this darkness is the hope that we'll have at least two or three candidate vaccines in the market by hopefully March or April 2021, but still that pushes back the calendar of recovery to 2021. That means for the industry, the hospitality industry, which has been the worst hit. I think the two sectors which have been really badly hit are the airline and the hospitality industries, which constitute the sum total of the travel and tourism sector. Now, we believe, I think most experts are unanimous that this is going to be a bad winter for the industry. We are also looking ahead to a bad first half of 2021. This is a crisis which is not blowing over very easily. So naturally, but we have to survive. We have to live on. We have to live for another day, as they say. And therefore, the big buzzwords today is cutting costs. I think everyone loves to talk about cutting costs. And sourcing local. In fact, the government, of course, has given us a great slogan, going vocal about local. I think there is not only a nationalistic imperative which is driving this trend, but there's also a very important imperative that, look, at a time when the GDP is constricting, we really do not have the luxury to spend on imports. And also, whatever money we can spend, we should spend it to develop a local industry. And that being the case, I think engineers have to alter the demand landscape in the light of these developments. We are very happy to have an engineering forum, which consists of people with diverse experiences and also represent diverse geographies. We have a couple of members of this forum who still haven't joined us because of technical reasons. But the ones who are already present and ready to go, we have Mr. Anil Malhotra, who's the president of Hotrimay. Hotrimay, as we know, is the country's biggest association of people who provide technical services and materials for the restaurant and hotel industry. So Mr. Malhotra is a veteran of this business. He knows more about automation and engineering than many of us, I think, can ever hope to achieve. His knowledge is almost encyclopedic. Therefore, we always count on him to set the ball rolling at these forums. We also have Mr. Lachimuthu Subbaraj from the Conrad Bengaluru. Conrad Bengaluru is a young hotel, but it is a trendsetting hotel in many ways. Of course, the Conrad brand itself is very well known for setting the brand standards for luxury around the world. We have Pawan Kumar from the Novotel Ahmedabad. As he will obviously bring a new perspective to the whole discussion because he comes from a he doesn't come from a tier one city, and nor does he represent a five-star luxury brand. So the demands on him must be completely different. It will be very interesting to see what he has to say about what it's like to be on his hot seat. We also have Rohit Sharma from New Delhi, from one of the most luxury, I mean, one of the benchmark setters in luxury, that is the Lodi, in the heart of Delhi, but which I often consider to be an industrial and engineering nightmare because of its vast open spaces and it's plunge pools in the rooms. I wonder how do they to start with prevent seepage, but that's we'll leave that discussion for some other day. Today we have more immediate issues to think about. We have Mr. Akash Singh, who represents Buildtrack, a company which is dedicated to developing automation systems. I think COVID-19 and the pressure it has built up on the industry to go for contracted service. I think we'll all agree that this imperative for contractless service has given another push to the whole business of automation. Hotels which are reluctant so far to go in for 100% automation will have no option but to look at automation more seriously than before. We'll ask Akash to make a presentation on Buildtrack and its offerings for the hotel industry, and then engage in a discussion with Mr. Subbaraj from Conrad Bengaluru. Mr. Subbaraj has done a lot of work on automation. We also have Mr. Basudev Singh Dadwal, Chief Engineer of the Park, New Delhi. Mr. Dadwal, can you hear us? Well, there is some problem he's having with his system, but Mr. Dadwal will be joining us very soon. We'll have one more gentleman, Mr. Narayan Ramamurthy from the Fortune Park Hotels, who'll also join in the middle of the discussion. Without further ado, I welcome Mr. Malhotra again and request him to please start the proceedings. He always manages to encapsulate the entire scope and of the discussion ahead in his speech. So in his inimitable way, I request him to please kick off the proceedings today.
Tanish ji, thank you very much. And I welcome all the panelists. I think Suresh ji has already given us a very good subject. And I would like to ask maybe not so difficult questions, but some difficult ones for the gentlemen who are sitting here. And we are all talking about engineering and the IT-related people who are associated with engineering, who are always at the helm of bringing in newer technologies to the hotels. And since you take these technologies forward when it comes to the implementations at the ground and grassroots level in your respective hotels, my first question to all the gentlemen here, and I would not request any one in particular, but anybody who wishes to answer this. Your costs that you have to keep within your reach, and considering that the rack rates are not really going northwards but southwards because of the reduced demand, how do you achieve this balance of implementing whatever you need to do, whether it could be things to do with your new QR codes or your contactless technologies or the new mantra in terms of keeping the the places sanitized with UV machines or the latest chemicals or the films and what have you, So there are thousand and one things which you would love to implement, but given the very constraint on budgets, which I think must be stressed upon you from the, your respective financial controllers, for whom I think they must have already cut budgets by some percentages already, which I think we are aware of. How do you really, reach that balance to give the very best to the guest in your respective hotel? So I think it was a very big question, but you can kindly answer that, each one of you. I'll be very grateful. Should we start with Mr.
As you know, we have two major expenses. One is from energy, and second is from our repair and maintenance. So repair and maintenance, the new normal, whatever chemicals, which something we cannot avoid. But energy saving is something that we can achieve. And you know, that is a major expense. So our target is to save as much as possible from energy and demand from the management to spend that money on my maintenance. So we also have a lot of technology to implement. As we discussed, we could not implement so many things, but we saw the savings in our utility cost. Then we have a right to ask the money back to implement all our technology. That's what we are actually doing during entire COVID. So during lockdown, with available team member 3 or 4, we have done so many changes in the system. Then we proved the management that we could save so much of money. Then obviously, then we got those money back, and we balanced.
How much money were you able to save by tweaking around with utilities? And what are some of the interesting innovations you introduced?
Yeah, and which way you were not saving earlier? Let's put it this way.
Yeah, that's right.
So it was not always in the mind. We learned to save so much because of the revenue was there. So when there was no business, then everybody started thinking in that direction, how much money we can save. So just before COVID, I used to consume 20,000 units. Now with the occupancy, we are getting like 100 rooms occupied today. Today I'm consuming only 10,000 units. Otherwise, if it was pre-COVID, year, then we used to consume at least 17,000-18,000 units. So what happened during COVID, a lot of people also changed their attitude. So everybody, are more particular in saving energy or not wasting the energy. So that, now it become our culture now. So then everybody putting their effort. So automatically our cost is come down.
Great. That's interesting. Hmm? So Mr. Sharma, carrying on from Mr. Malhotra, in a setup like yours, how do you cut costs?
So which is your number one, item where you're cutting costs? Let me put it this way.
We have two types of the expenses majorly in the auto industry. One is the R&M and second one is the energy. So in R&M segment, to upkeep the building, to maintain the standards, we don't have so much cushion over there. But anyhow, we manage our R&M in the two segments. One is the essential for the all gas related services and utilities, and as well as for the back of the houses. And another one in the energy, in COVID-19 lockdown time, after unlocking one time frame, we have commissioned the automatic tube cleaning system for our chillers. As all of us know that the chiller is the major consumption part of the electricity. So that we have commissioned the automatic tube cleaning system. Definitely, this is the energy saving and the technology based system. So our head pressure in chiller segments, so that we are getting the saving through the APC. And the lobby is the one of the hotel who have the plunge pools in the all apartments and all rooms. So that the another cost is the PNG. Huge cost is PNG. So that before COVID, we installed the Hydromax system for our boilers and the hot water generators. So there is a 20% savings in the energy in the PNG also. So that we are getting the energy savings through the these two systems and LED is the very common feature for the each facility now. And whole building is equipped with the building management system. So that we have our sensors regularly calibrated to get the efficiency in the through the BMS system.
Right.
And for the COVID, that Lodi has the the certifications through the British Safety Council for the OHS, for the occupational health and safety. And Lodi is the one of the 5-star hotel in India who got the BSC COVID-19 assessment certificate from the British Safety Council also.
Mr. Pawan Kumar, what has been your big breakthrough in terms of cost cutting?
Yeah, definitely. I'll just put in another way. Like, this pandemic has taught us so many things. It has many things which has disadvantages disadvantages. There are so many things to learn from this pandemic. The time frame where the hotels are shut down or shut down. So there are like that time was, you know, experimenting new things and new ideas, innovative ideas, so that we can, you know, match up the like our cost structure. So, and our majorly focus was HVAC only. So like HVAC, there is a huge scope of saving, and like we did that. We installed BFDs on the pumps, HVAC pumps, and by that, like we had saved around, you know, 7 to 8% over last year. I'm talking about, you know, the average comparing to the total energy to HVAC. So 7 to 8% we had saved, and apart from that, there are like if I'll talk, there are two things: fixed cost and variable cost. So there's a fixed cost. It considered to be increasing day by day or year by year. So, but collectively, Accor Hotels, they have taken the initiative, and we spoken to our all service provider, and we negotiated the costing or rates, and like roughly around 10 to 15% saving we got from our service partners also. So that was a huge amount. That was the thing. And in terms of variable cost, so as I said, HLP, there are few things where we had worked on. It was like HVAC, which I have already told about. Then, this hot water generation system. Earlier, it used to be, 24/7 and 360. But there are huge scope of saving in terms of looking for, BFDs for pump, or there are some tweaking to the running hours in terms of, it depends upon the, the city and the area and the setup. So like here we have, D-super heater system for our chiller plant. So during daytime, we used to maintain the temperature at hot water, desirable temperature with that only. We don't run hot water boilers during daytime. So that was, we have invented during this, pandemic time. Earlier it was 24/7, 365. And other things like energy monitoring and control measure, it plays a huge role. There roughly around, like if we are monitoring and we are putting, a suitable measure in place, then we can save up to 15 to 30% of energy. And, mm-hmm. This time, collectively, the entire hotel was in same, the target was same. Like we have to save the energy without, compromising on the safety of the building, without compromising on the occupant, whomsoever is staying inside the hotel, whether it's employees or guests. So these are the measures we have taken. And apart from that, like technology-wise, there are a few things. I cannot say that we have done so many things, but there are a few things which are cost-effective and, which are the demand of this, current time. So
I want to ask you one question. Whenever you talk about new technologies, to cut costs, or to reduce consumption, but you're talking about some investment, aren't you? How soon do you recover that investment?
Like I'll tell you the things, whatever we have right now done, there was a...
You've unmuted yourself, sir. You muted yourself, sorry.
Sorry, can you hear?
Yeah, can you repeat what you said?
Yeah, so like there was a minimal investment we have done. Earlier, we used to have the BFD on our HVAC plant, like pumps, but those are running on full capacity.
Mm.
So we install, two temperature sensor. We did R&D and we installed two temperature sensor on the decoupler line where the entire amount of energy, goes for it also. So we installed two temperature controller over there, and by that, doing that, we have, the pumps which were running at 50 hertz, we have reduced down to 30 or 35 hertz. So there was a huge saving.
That's right. Okay. So which justifies the investment you make in the new technology?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, Mr. Varathra, you've heard them, I'll ask Akash Singh to have his presentation ready meanwhile. He's going to talk about automation. Mr. Varathra, are you going to, do you have some opening thoughts on automation and the imperative of automation in this this age that we're living in?
Yeah, I would actually, you know, put this this thought stream to Akash right away. And I would like, you know, away of course from your presentation, I would like your thoughts, since you're an automation expert. You know, we had started with the good old world of analog and going to digital, and we hear about, you know, the online automation, and then came the Zigbee and the Wi-Fi's and everything, you know. You tell me what would be best suited for, you know, the Indian scenario, and how soon should the hotels actually adapt the voice activation towards, you know, automation, specifically in guest rooms?
So, absolutely.
Sorry, it was all along the number line. I started from 1960s, but... you gave us a gist.
Yeah, absolutely. So voice, let me first start with my journey. So 5 years back, there was no voice. So people were not so comfortable, especially in Indian infrastructure, they were not so comfortable with the app itself, for example. For instance, when the voice came into the picture, now the COVID came into the picture. So this voice has actually drove the complete market in terms of providing the context nowadays, especially after the COVID happened. So we have been receiving quite a few inquiries. I mean, a lot of customers now are coming back to put voice devices into the guest room to provide the complete touchless experiences. Now, since the COVID and combining with the voice, the companies like us, now we are pushing that innovation of boundaries, that how to innovate something out of it to provide our customers and the clients to those kind of service in terms of providing whether the touchless experience or the improving the efficiency of throughout the operational team at the hotel or the guest inside the guest room as well. So what we have been trying to do, for example, like controlling earlier, in the past, now that controlling your lighting, your curtain and blinds, it was only on the app. It was only from the switches, from the remotes. Nowadays, all have been combined on the voice, as Anilji, you rightly mentioned. Now, in addition to these traditional controls, like controlling your light, fan, air conditioning, now we are pushing that boundaries to give you that service request and locking your door, you're controlling your do not disturb, ordering your food and something. So now we are reaching at that particular pinnacle point to provide these kind of services inside the room, which is again an amazing experience to the customer, as well as now it is fulfilling the requirement of providing that complete touchless experience. So that has been our experience so far. I mean, in this year, from the last 2 years, since the voice came into the picture.
So I believe, talk about a guest room and with a system, let's say, which is a voice activated system. And we are not talking about more frills, you know, to the room. How much is a per room cost on such a system that a hotel needs to pay?
So, voice again, it's a
ballpark.
Voice again, it's a 3000 device, 3000 per device per room. And any customer can, any hotelier can take and they can put across the hotel. This is the one cost. This is, I mean, very fraction amount of money which they can pay. In addition to voice devices, there are certain relays, there are certain devices we need to be procured to get automated inside the room. So, ballpark figure, I mean, if we can start with a very basic solution. So, I would like to give you that 22,000 per room cost that can be the starting point for the hoteliers.
Okay.
So, Akash, I believe you have a video which you'd like to share with us.
Yeah, I have a couple of slides. So, I would like to start. And since it's a great panel to have your feedback, especially with Anilji and Subharas and Pavanji and Rohit, with all of you. So, I'll share a couple of things. So, we are primarily an IoT company. So we have always believed in designing and innovating solution to the customer's front and always taking feedback from them to again come up with some kind of new solution. Since COVID has really pushed us back 2 years, I mean, down the line, especially the hospitality. So we thought that, I mean, rather than giving you that, focusing on that smart room controls and like ringing that bell to that smartphone control, voice control. So we have gone other way around. So even today at this platform, we would like to share what are the key challenges. Like all of you rightly mentioned that there is no occupancy inside the hotel. So only thing to gain those revenue or minimize or offset those losses to cut down your operating costs. So I'm going to touch upon many different points where any hotel customer, any hotelier can cut down the cost in terms of energy. That is our first focus. That is our ideology at this company. So I'll be sharing some of the solutions and products which can be deployed to reduce a significant amount of saving. Yes, I hope all of you can see my screen.
Absolutely. I can see it.
Yeah. So we at Buildtrack, we have various kind of solution, but primarily related to IoT enabled solutions. So we have smart meter, we have current transformers, we have to monitor the energy consumption, we have smart touch switches, voice enabled guest room services in terms of controlling your devices as well as the services. So we have variety of things, but to cut down the energy costs and along with energy, the operating costs as well. So I'll be focusing on, this is the data which, I mean, at first glance that you can see, you all know, I mean, better than us. So we have just picked up some data from the industry that how the complete figure has been distributed among all these groups, whether energy, personal, marketing and maintenance cost. So energy has been really the pain point from the customer side, especially nowadays. So I'll be focusing on that particular part. So the whole solution we have is being divided into three categories. One is the providing that solution which cut down your operating cost, improved your guest experience, and enhance that safety of the guest as well as the staff. So first, I'm going to touch upon to reduce the energy cost. So this is a landscape which you can see, which is distributed again in terms of guest room. Guest room consumes more or less 50%. Others consume 5%, 10% ratio, 15% ratio. These data, I think the chief engineer point of view, you will come to know with some different figure that, but this is a ballpark figure which we have found based on the survey which have been done in the market. So now quickly jumping on to reducing that energy cost. So I'll first start with the guest room operation. So this is the first way which we see, and it can be easily deployed at any existing or new property. So to giving that MyFair base card or frequency base card has already been in the market. So wherever the hotel, in which are the hotel which are not having these frequency based key card system, we can easily enable their lighting and air conditioning with this frequency based key card system. And this will only operate with the given card which hotel has assigned to the customer. So generally what happens, that people come, they insert their credit card or paper and all. So they leave the house and they leave the room and everything gets on. So we want to minimize and we want to save at that particular front. So we can easily replace with this key card, whether it's at any existing property, and we can either switch off the lighting and air conditioning or set back that air conditioning temperature based on this card. So it's complete wireless. There is no aesthetic change which we require in terms of implementing at any existing property. The second way of achieving energy efficiency inside the guest room is providing the combination of sensors, that is occupancy sensor with the combination of door sensors. So what happens? So whenever there is someone inside the room or somebody has opened the door, the air conditioning temperature should be adjusted accordingly. So let's say if I'm leaving that particular room, the sensors will sense that particular moment that there is nobody inside the room. It will switch off the complete lighting. It will preset the air conditioning temperature or the switch off the complete air conditioning system. So there is a great amount of saving in terms of achieving that energy efficiency inside the guest room. So this is the second way of doing that particular solution. So now everybody is now talking about QR code. So QR code can also be implemented with the QR code. Customer can generate a temporary web link. So from that web link, customer can raise the service request. They can control the in-room control like lighting, curtains, they can raise the service request like ordering a water bottle, ordering a food, which can be integrated back to your POS or something, or your existing PMS system, it can be integrated. So all these data we bring back to the centralized console, whatever that being generated at the room level, it can be trickles down to your housekeeping, your front desk management. So wherever the customer wants. The third way of achieving that energy efficiency across the hotel, it's a very basic and effective solution. While placing these occupancy sensors, these sensors to control your common area lighting, to kitchen ventilation, and the exhaust vent. Because people often forget about these ventilation and exhaust vent, but they consume a significant amount of energy across the hotel. Especially, I'll be coming in the basement. Like this is my second next slide. So in the basement, there are two systems where we can save energy. One is the ventilation, and second is the lighting. So we can easily place at any existing facility or new facility. The first sensor we place is the CO sensor, that is a carbon monoxide sensor. So based on the CO level inside the basement, it will control the ventilation and it saves a significant amount of energy in the basement area. The second way of achieving energy efficiency while controlling the lighting based on the movement. So we place microwave sensor in across the basement. So based on the movement of vehicle or the people, so it will be the whole ventilation and lighting will be demand based. So whenever they will turn on when there is a need of it. Otherwise, there is a huge wastage because it is continuously running inside the property where there is no control of those wastage. And we often not talk about this system. So these sensor will help to minimize the wastage. It will create a demand based system across the property. Now I'm entering into the hotel. The area where we can save energy or give you the operational efficiency as well. The ballroom or the banquet room, where it's a huge area where the large number of lightings are there. The air conditioning consumptions are used in those areas. So we can easily place our retrofit devices. Again, I'm emphasizing the fact that it can be placed at any existing facility as well. That's the biggest advantage of having these retrofit devices. So you can easily integrate the lighting, the air conditioning, and the engineering team can play around with it. So they can use their lighting based on the demand inside the room. They can set the temperature of the air conditioning based on the demand of those areas. So it is purely, anybody can control these devices with the palm of their hand. So everything will come on their app, as can be integrated with the Wi-Fi. So whoever is the concerned person, while sitting at their place, they can control the whole property based on the demand inside those places. The outdoor lighting can be integrated with the timer-based system, which most of the hotels might be having it, but it can be integrated with the same system. Now I'll be a couple of things I'll be talking about how to save cost in terms of the water consumption. So in terms of the water segment, the water pump and water management can be integrated back to your BMS or our platform. So you will have the complete transparent data, what has been the duration of your pump, whether it's what is the real-time status. I mean, what is the real-time status of a water tank? So these all data points that can be given back to the engineering team at their comfort. You can generate a compliance report for the STP water quality. So that can also be given very easily at any point of time. So now I think Mr. Pawan was talking about the energy monitoring. Now to us, we see that to achieve any particular energy, first it should be visible to the customer. Because we only know how many units we have consumed across the property. But in silos, we don't know which particular room has consumed a lot of energy and what is the bifurcation among a guest room, what is the bifurcation among this common area, the other side of the property. So we don't know the bifurcation at the hotel level, if I'm not wrong. So maybe some clients might have implemented something. But this is how we want to give those data in silos so that we can actually pinpoint that okay, these are the rooms, these are the guest rooms where I'm consuming a lot of energy, and which should not happen. I mean, that is beyond the threshold level. So we can easily achieve those things, and we can, once we have pinpoint those rooms or the area, so we can easily implement the solution according to it. So smart meters can be placed whether inside the room, if you want to have energy consumption per room basis, you want to have a water consumption. So all these monitoring can easily be given back to the system. Now, BMS, this is the part of the BMS. So I'll be not touching this these particular slide because it's already there. We all know that all the asset infrastructure management from the single point we can manage, like your pumps, motor, DG, STP, your electrical panels and all. So that can also be integrated with the same system. So now I'm quickly jumping on the how we can enhance the guest experience, especially nowadays. So as I think I was about to talk on the voice. So Anilji, you rightly pointed out at the beginning of the session that you asked. So voice has been the forefront in the business right now in terms of providing the guest experience. So, but one thing I want to talk about, that any existing hotel can also offer these devices, because I think there is a myth that this can't happen at any existing property, but it's not. We can easily place retrofit devices at any existing property with your existing air conditioning system, with your existing switches. So all the retrofit devices can be placed, and we can give you that app and voice enable system to improve the guest experience. And obviously and providing the contactless experience as well. So now the one thing which I would like to highlight those part, all the room data, whether it's air conditioning data point, whether it's lighting or the occupancy of those room, we bring all those data back to your centralized system, whether your property manager, whether your contact management. So if any room is being, what is the occupancy level of those rooms? What is the air conditioning consumption of the operation of those rooms? So all the data will be given back to the system. So at the end of the month, at the end of the quarter, we can quickly analyze those data and take better decision, because it's all about data. Data is now new currency. So we should have those data in place to make a better decision in coming months. So that has been the main focus for new properties. For new constructions or the renovation, the same controls for the in-room automation can be integrated with the smart switch. So this is again from the aesthetic point of view. So while removing your existing switches and placing these customized smart touch switches, so it has the complete range: your thermostat, your outdoor panel, your indoor panel. It covers the entire guest room experience. It has a customization feature. So your brand logo, your all the interior requirements can easily be fulfilled with these switches. So now I'll be talking about how to enhance the operational efficiency. So the same app, the same voice where we are putting inside the guest room. So we can give all these points like Hilton is doing, like providing a menu card services. So we can integrate that part. We can integrate amenity brochures. We can integrate nearby attractions. So any client, any hotelier can remove all the hard touch points, hard book kind of a thing which has been running inside the hotel. So everything will come on the customer's app. There is no need to put iPad or something. So they can just download, they can create a temporary web link while putting a QR code at the front desk. And all this service requests, do not disturb, everything they can run from the just at their fingerprints, and same can be integrated with the voice. So I already touched this part. So with the voice, now there is not a single thing that you cannot control. So more or less, whatever the customer needs nowadays, it can be integrated in a contactless manner. So whether it's lighting, water bottle, your scenes, profiles, everything, your do not disturb, everything can be integrated. So again, guest service requests will be visible to housekeeping with their respective team or the front desk management. All the maintenance requests, all the housekeeping requests will go to that respective room. So this particular comes under the operational efficiency. So now we can have all the staff can have their apps where they can receive all these notifications. So in terms of enhancing the safety. I think Hyatt has this mandate because we have done the Kolkata one, where we have given a very unique product that's called panic buttons to improve their security, the safety for their staff. So in isolated areas where, I mean, there is not a frequent movement, so we can place a safety sensors, or we can have a safety feature inside the voice. It's a very unique feature to have. So customer just have to say if they are not feeling well, if they are facing some kind of difficulty, they just have to say, okay, Alexa, Google Help. So it will immediately create emergency alert back to the centralized system. So this is how the technology is moving so fast that the emergency system can easily be implemented as over the voice as well. So I think these were the main things which I wanted to talk about at this platform, and I would now like to hear from each one of you.
Yes, I think this is very, very exciting product developments have shown. Mr. Sabaraj, could you take over from here and talk about what's your reaction to what you've seen?
It's a very interesting subject. I think the IoT is the latest happening in the technology now. So earlier, you know, there all the BMS and all the old fashion technology. Now IoT is going very well. So we also started implementing some IoT already in our property. So like we got a different company from Chennai who was doing my water management. So complete my STP, water treatment plant, everything contained with the sensors. So I get my telephone dashboard and web dashboard, I get all the data. But very good thing that that voice control in other systems. So now, like as you said, all the sensors, during COVID, we are doing this job only in the hotel. So all the basement, we put a sensors. Even my office also, my guys put a sensor. If I step out, and the light will go off.
Right.
Every corner, every back of the house, every parking lot, we put a sensors. Only thing, we did not go to that level of IoT or voice control. And secondly, whichever, like I also speak to so many vendors, IoT is one of the cheapest solution also available today. So like the BMS, you need to make a BMS of the complete building. Like, but IoT is like a very tailor made. You want to just do two equipment today, you just spend some money, you put two equipment today. Tomorrow when you say, like you save some money, then ask manager, sir, give me some more money. And you buy one more device, you keep adding that. And I'm sure you will also agree that once they give us a training to engineer, then I need to just buy product from them. I can keep on adding in my app. Is it right, Mr. Akas?
Yeah, absolutely. Like, fair point, sir.
And very user friendly. So I also promoting this IoT to many engineers. So because we tried something, so I also asked my IoT vendor to give some ideas. So like we started with only for water monitoring, but last 2 months we also added pressure, like a chilled water temperature, the water pressure. So that company was not doing that, but I am giving my input to add all those sensors. So now, so like my hotel is like their laboratory. So whatever I want to do it, they will install their sensors. I think it's a very good technology. I think everybody has to take over, implement this technology in their hotel, and it's very good cost saving also.
So basically, in the last, I'll talk about year 2020. So what is the newest thing that you have actually implemented during COVID, Mr. Subbaraj?
Sir, as I said, the moment we know there is no guest is going to come to the hotel, I'd be working with only 4 guys in my department.
Hmm.
Okay. And we also keep, we need to keep them engaged.
Right.
So what we have done is just we open all our energy book of 2018 and 19, gone through, we also, fortunately, we had a lot of meters already then a part of our project.
Okay.
So we gone through all the parameters, then we analyzed, the area wise where we could save energy. Then Mr. Sauris knows we put all the sensors in guest rooms. There are plenty of sensors in my stock. So complete basement, we converted with automation.
So that then is what you did to keep yourself occupied. Okay.
Yes. And then we thought when the hotel was operation, how much that LED is going to consume. But by adding 3 watts or 30 watts, my saving is coming around 800 units per day only by, the parking lights or the corridor lights.
Right.
Yeah, absolutely.
So then secondly, for like the hot water system. We have a digital regulating valve in the hotel for the hot water system. but we were not, you know, monitoring our area temperatures or the, you know, the requirement of the pumps.
Right.
So every corner of, you know, the system, we put a temperature sensor, timers. Then we not spend much money. We must have spent like maybe 10,000-15,000 rupees to all these controllers.
Right.
But only thing is the thought process. Then we connected everything. Now if I set like 42 degree, means all 24 hours, you just maintain 42 degree, not even in a 42.5 or not even 41.5.
Right.
So this comfort also, you know, taken care of. And we can't, wasting any energy. So I could see a lot of changes in, you know, our consumption pattern. I can, you know, proudly tell, even when I go 100% occupancy also, my consumption will not go what I was doing in the year 2019. I think COVID has helped us in other way like this.
Yeah, absolutely.
I think good thing that has happened is that we have put our minds together to think differently, which would have been very difficult otherwise if it was just drilled in us, you know. But these difficult times have taught us a lot of new things, and especially like I think the way we are sitting here and we are comfortable talking to each other. I think we had a mindset where, you know, we had to be in a meeting with physically everybody there, you know. This, I think, according to me, is a very good mindset which has set into our minds, you know. And
in fact,
I hope that it will stay this way.
In fact, the most recent prediction of Bill Gates is that face-to-face meetings will now become a thing of history.
Yeah.
I think people have discovered the utility and the cost savings.
I mean, I hope so in India. In
meetings like this.
I hope so.
Yeah, at least it avoids it, helps us avoid traffic, you know. And we can always be on time.
You save so much of cost as it is, you know.
Right.
And I remember, you know, having done so many morning, evening to Mumbai or Chennai, you know, just to finalize deals and things like that, you know. So, I mean, we don't need to really do all that.
That's right.
So, Rohitji, my next question to you would be, if you were given an open hand, let's say to finances, what would be the single new technology that you would like to implement in your hotel? Supposing if budget was not a constraint.
Rooms automation, sir. As in Lodi, we have the minimum room size is 1300 square feet. So that definitely we will go for the rooms automation. And in other areas, we have the automation. We have fully equipped BMS, water level sensors for the water tanks, fire pump room, flooding monitoring. We have all the automations in our building, and as well as for the online monitoring system for the sewage treatment plant also, so that we can monitor the pH, TSS values. So that definitely I will go for the rooms automations if I will have the free end.
How about you, Mr. Subraj?
Sir, it was fortunate, like the hotel is a very new hotel.
Yes.
And we also want to do a LEED certification and all. So we went ahead like so much automation or optimization, you know, it was done during the project itself.
Right.
Even the building, you know, we divided into three portions, and then we have a three different pumping.
Okay.
So now also like I don't operate the complete hotel. So when we are taking a room only in the upper floor, I don't operate the middle section of the building.
No, fine. But I'm giving you a wish list, you know. So I mean, number one on your wish list would be what? Still, if and you are getting all the finances also.
Okay.
I'm not your FC, but I'm still saying.
So we have room. Yeah. So we have room automation.
Right.
But unfortunately, it is not connected to my office. So I can. I do not know what is happening in another room.
It's all
control. So this was always my dream. You know, I was talking to my owner.
So have it two way. Okay.
Yeah. Wire and then bring to a BMS system so that we can monitor from the remote. Suppose I guess something is working, not working. We could be able to see at least. And then we also can see how many rooms are occupied, those things. So this was always in my top list. So if I get a money, I will do it as a first.
Okay.
From all this that we have discussed, we have, from Internet of Things to, you know, automation, we've talked about so many different matters. We've talked about cost controls. But now the say in September 2021, if we expect a complete return to original levels of occupancy, Mr. Subraj, this is a question for you. The consumption will again go up. You know, your energy consumption will go up. From 10,000, it'll go up to 20,000 again, maybe. So how do you ensure that that 20,000 comes down permanently to about 15,000 or something, or 17,000? Is it possible to do that?
Yeah, so sir, so what are you done during COVID or now? This is like energy saying something, you do it today, then it is going to be forever. So when the occupancy is going, pick up like even 100% in September 2021, definitely the consumption will go little higher than what I consume today, but definitely will less than what I used to consume in the year 2019. That much I can
I think that's what you've achieved during this lockdown period.
15-20% at least you will be able to, you know, reduce. Because when you open the hotel, you don't have enough time to test the system also.
Right.
But now we got a historical data of last 2 years. So we have optimized so many systems, right from chilled water system to steam system, hot water system. So every system is optimized. You know, people also understood the system, how it is functioning, how the distribution. So right. We have a data and we have experience of the building. So both work together, and I'm very confident that we will be able to, you know, definitely not going above that last, 2019, but definitely 10-15% less than what we done. That's how we budgeted also.
Yeah. In fact, that's the way, you know, Rohit, I think Akash's presentation, I was very interested in seeing the emphasis they're putting on underground, the basement parking areas. I think I never considered basement parking to be a guzzler of energy. And now that he's talking about it, I remember often, I would have dinner at Emporio, DLF Emporio, which is a luxury mall. Then I come down and the basement is fully lit and all the ventilators are on full blast, but they're like all together 6 or 10 cars there, you know. So do you think, I don't know, of course, whether Lodi has such a large basement parking, but I'm sure you've got, everything is super magnum size at the Lodi. So isn't this an area of concern? Isn't this an area you should be looking into?
Yeah, definitely. That in Emporio, I believe they have their ventilation with the CO sensors.
Mm.
I also went there for some benchmarking.
Okay.
This is a part of the DLF and Lodi.
Oh, yeah, of course. DLF Emporio is your sister concern. Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. And even we have the CO sensors in our parking for the ventilation system. And for the night when the occupancy is low for in terms of the vehicles, for that we have the dual system for the parking lights. In night time, only the emergency light works and the whole lights are timers.
Okay, great.
And, we try to, to maintain the CCTV levels also.
Okay. Right. So all this leads to energy saving at the end of the day.
Definitely, if your ventilation system is equipped with the CO sensor and
definitely
it will save the ventilation energy.
What do you think are the scope of implementing what he's talking about, in a hotel like yours?
So the presentation, the technology, it was very good. But I also as Mr. Subaraju said, there are so many things, it's standalone things in the market. So it's good technology, but I can say that every part of the hotel, I can say it's not that much necessary, to install the whole setup of things, especially basement he was talking about. So in the property which recently opened up, they have, the setup for CO based sensor. And
absolutely.
And for public area, especially standalone, this motion sensors or PID sensors are there. And especially what I was really, the air conditioning he was talking about, for especially for guest rooms, so that was the good part. So where that can be done for especially for guest room, because we don't, earlier it was the practice that we generally don't consider guest room consumptions, we, you know, we look for, you know, bigger equipments and other things, but it's a huge consumption which going to the guest rooms. So that was good thing. And like before COVID, so we were, you know, talking to a company, Secure Meter, because they also have this kind of thing for, especially for guest room air conditioning. So we were in a talk, but after that, this thing comes in and it didn't work out. So like we were in favor of doing that. So
I think, you know, Akash being a good salesperson, he put out all the candies and all the chocolates and all the goodies in front of us. He was tempting us with a lot of things, but I guess you have to pick and choose. I mean,
yeah, absolutely.
According to your needs,
absolutely.
And your budgets. You know?
So it's a wide array of product solutions. Now it's just like a la carte menu.
Right, exactly. Yeah. His is like a good old fashioned a la carte menu, which is like a good 120 items.
Sir, I have two questions to ask from the panelists.
Please.
So one part, which we would like to have that data. What is that energy consumption? What is the percentage of across the hotel from the guest room? So is it 50%, 60%? What is that ratio? Maybe if you'd like to share from one of your experience.
Yeah, Akash, in, like it will be less than 50% only, because, you know, the biggest, you know, guzzler in the hospitality industry or in a hotel is, you know, chiller plant.
Yeah,
that
absolutely.
Generally consume about, you know, 50 to 60 or 40 to 50, 60%. So it must be less than that only, in my perspective.
Of all the guest rooms.
Yeah.
So what about at Lodhi, Rohit ji?
Consider only the lighting.
I'm talking about complete consumption, lighting.
Yeah, I understand the electricity load and the electricity load for the chillers as well.
Yeah, correct.
So it's around 35 to 40%, as we have the large spa and the large others area, club areas also. But our guest room consumptions averagely 35 to 40%.
But again, this must be a larger portion out of 100%.
Yeah. Right? So we have the room, we have the, you know, big room sizes. Minimum room sizes is 1300 square feet. In general hotel, you know, you have the one FCU in the your regular room, and we have the, you know, two FCUs in room, and with in some apartments, we have the 13 FCUs. That's why the in terms of the all consumptions, like electricity plus the electrical consumption for the chillers, for the guest room, so it's averagely around 35 to 40%.
Right. And what would be the second most area where, I mean, most consumption will happen?
Definitely it is that after the back of the houses and the spa club area, we have the
club area, you know,
we have the very big spa area. With all big treatment rooms, all, you know, steam sections, the big steam chambers for the hammam. So club is also major.
Fair enough, sir. Fair enough.
Also, it will be like second is must be a public area only, because it's a guest facing area and we could not do as like so much things in that area. So it must be public area only, as my colleague said.
Right.
Thank you.
You know, I don't know, as a guest, and this is something I'm just throwing in, you know, nothing very technical, but as a guest, whenever I go to a hotel, first thing I do is switch off all the lights, you know, and only keep the light which is necessary to keep on, you know. I mean, I hope more and more people do that, because, you know, I was once, you know, calculating there about 10 or 12, or how many per room, there, I mean, at least 12, minimum 12 LEDs that are, you know, how many lights are there in the room?
Yeah, 10 to 12 lights.
10 to 12
lights, yeah. Now, if you can switch off 10 of those lights, you know, you save that much electricity. And if each guest does it, you know, we can save a lot of electricity, you know. And I think that is one personal lesson I've learned in life. I mean, I don't know whether it really saves or not, but we don't need sensors or anything. Even when you're in the room, we can save electricity. Mr. Murutha, what is your message from today?
Well, I think what we need to do is, as Mr. Subraj had said it very, very nicely, that, you know, these learnings we need to keep with ourselves and take them forward in the good times also, you know, so that we can take the we can take the fruits of what we have learned in the hard times to be enjoyed also in the good times to come. And I'm very sure that hospitality is going to come back like never before in a much more, let's say occupancy-wise, much, much higher occupancies. Probably there won't be rooms available in hotels anymore, you know, as soon as the vaccine is out. And I would reckon, let's not get to conclusion or jump to conclusions immediately with the vaccines, as they say, are coming in February, March. But as you very rightly said, we should be prepared for good times only in the second half of 2021. This is what I need to say.
Yes, I think till then, let's try to rack our brains and keep thinking of new ways to save costs. And also maybe discover vendors like Biltrac, which are coming up with new solutions, new automation devices, which I think will go a long way in conserving all the costs that we're looking at. Thank you so much, gentlemen, for giving your valuable time for this discussion. And till we meet again, and hopefully, in better times when occupancies are high and you're all, spending money on new investments and new hotels. Till then, let's try to save money. Let's try to cut costs. And let's really, what they say, tighten our belts to loosen them up at the right time, right moment. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone, and stay safe. Thank you.
Yeah.